sewers, and welcome to another Ann Arbor Sewing Center Sew It Yourself project. Today we'll be helping you create your very own lunch sack. What you will need for this simple project is a half of a yard of main fabric, a half of a yard of interior fabric, a half of a yard of fusible webbing, a rotary cutter, a ruler, and thread. To begin, cut both your main fabric and lining fabric into a 13-inch by 34-inch rectangle. We cut our fabric on the fold to make it easier to cut. If you do that, cut your fabric 13 inches by 17 inches so it unfolds to 13 inches by 34 inches. Next, cut a piece of fusible web 13 inches by 34 inches. Afterwards, taking your main fabric, iron your piece of fusible web to the wrong side of the fabric. Once your webbing is adhered to the fabric, carefully peel off the paper from the fusible web. If an area is not ironed securely on the back, re-iron. Now, take your interior fabric and iron it to the wrong side of the main fabric. Both wrong sides will be ironed together, having the fusible web in between the two wrong sides of the fabric. You should now have one 13-inch by 34-inch rectangle. Next, fold the rectangle in half, creating a 13-inch by 17-inch rectangle. On the fold, cut two 2.5 by 2.5-inch notches from the bottom corners of your fabric. Afterwards, with your main fabric facing out, sew along both outside edges a 1/4 inch. You will sew along the complete side. Do not turn and sew the notches. Next, flip the sack inside out and iron the sides so that the stitching on the sides of the bag are right against the edge. Stitch these sides down using a bigger seam allowance than 1/4 inch. We used a wider foot to sew a 3/8 inch seam. This will cover the seam so there is not a raw edge. Make sure to check that your original stitching is not showing on the main fabric. To continue, turn the bag right side out so the lining is facing each other and start to form the bottom of the sack. Open up the notch on one side of the bag, making sure that the seam is matching up in the middle to the bottom of the sack. If you have some excess fabric from one side of the sack, cut this off. Sew this corner using a 1/4 inch seam allowance. Repeat for the other side. Afterwards, flip the sack inside out, press the corners out, and sew the corners down using a bigger seam allowance than 1/4 inch. Again, we used a wider foot to sew a 3/8 inch seam. This will cover the seam so there is not a raw edge. Now that the bottom of the sack is completed, it is time to sew the top of the sack. Depending on how tall you want the sack to be, you can alter the way you want to sew the top edge. We decided to press down the top about 1/2 inch and then rolled that over about 3/4 inch. After pressing, we used an edging foot to sew down the top of the sack's edge. We are now done with the sewing. To help the bag take the shape of a lunch sack, we folded in the top of the bag, pressed, and then rolled the top. And that's it. You now have a personalized lunch sack to bring to work or school. On behalf of Ann Arbor Sewing Center, we hope you enjoyed this Sew It Yourself tutorial, and we would love it if you shared your new lunch sack with us on our Facebook page. We hope you have a great day, and happy sewing!